Hey there, thanks for making it this far into the video. It's going to be a bit longer than that, so as interesting things happen along the way, I'm going to jump in. We're going to be going all the way up to the Yukon, out to the west coast to Vancouver, Victoria, Tofino, and then down the western seaboard to San Francisco, and all the way back. So as interesting things happen along the way, I'll jump in, but other than that, enjoy the music. Here we are coming into Sudbury. This is a big mining town about 500 kilometers away from Ottawa. And here there's two museums. One's called Science North, which is about to come up, and the other one is the big nickel mine. So you get to see all the biodiversity within Ontario, and you get to see the big Canadian nickel, which is the size of a house. And this is a shot from the mine tour, where you get to go 25 meters underground and see how miners used to work 100 years ago. So that was really interesting. This is all from the first day, so the next stop is Sault Ste. Marie, about 800 kilometers away, and that's where the first day will stop.
You're
So here we are driving beside Lake Superior, which is actually a lake which is 44% bigger than Croatia, which was pretty impressive to find out. So here are just some nice shots from along a lookout, which is looking over the lake. So the next town that's up is called Wawa, Ontario, and Wawa means wild goose in Ojibwe. So about 40 to 50 years ago, the townspeople still had to take a train to work because as the Trans-Canada Highway was being put in, it actually missed the town. So after many years of people trying to fight to have the road put in, the road was finally put in around 1960, I believe, and this wild goose was put up to commemorate that event. And it's a major tourist attraction when driving across Canada through this part.
I was blown away. What could I say? It all seemed to make sense. You're taking away everything, and I can't do without.
So here we are coming into Thunder Bay, which not much really happens here. There was a Tim Hortons, there was a Canadian Tire. I picked up an air compressor to pump up the air in my tires, put in some extra oil into my car, some windshield washer fluid, some basic maintenance, some Tim Hortons for myself. That was probably the 50th time up to that spot that I got Tim Hortons. And yeah, the next stop is Kenora, which is another 700-800 kilometers. Kenora is a cottage town near Winnipeg, so even 100 years ago, a lot of people from Winnipeg would go to Kenora for cottage country. Kenora's other claim to fame is the Kenora Thistles, which were the smallest NHL hockey team to ever win a Stanley Cup in around 1905. Don't quote me on that date. Being strong, holding on, can't let it bring us down. My life with you means everything, so I won't give up that easily. I'll blow it away, blow it away. Can we make this something good? Cause it's all misunderstood.
Yeah.
here we are coming into Kenora, Ontario, a cottage town. Lots of lakes around here, prime cottage country. As I came into town, there was a big festival going on called Harbor Fest. Lots of people, food. It was a good way to sort of stretch my legs from the car and keep going on to Winnipeg, which is about 2 more hours away. So that's next on the list. In Manitoba, and the prairies have begun. We've just crossed into the central time zone, and in one of these frames we also crossed the longitudinal center of Canada. So the middle of Canada was crossed here. Winnipeg is maybe 15 more real minutes away, and we'll be pulling into Winnipeg shortly. Here we are pulling into Winnipeg, a very pretty town in the middle of the prairies. There's the Assiniboine River and the Red River that meet in the middle of the town at the Forks. This is the Manitoban legislature right here. This is Louis Riel, who I'll mention again shortly. And this is the Canadian Museum of Human Rights, which is the first and only national museum that is outside of Ottawa, Ontario. I spent a great week in Winnipeg, and after that I was so inspired by the story of Louis Riel and the Métis, and a link will be below for that, that I decided to take a 300 kilometer detour to go check out the site of Batoche, Saskatchewan, which was where the Métis made their final stand against the Canadian government. So more on that in the details, but enjoy the prairies.
I'm so dang graceful. I grew up really wanna go front, but that's what you get when Texas raised you. Y'all can't stop me. Go hard like I got an 808 on my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the beat like I gave a little speed to a great white shotgun country.
Oh, raise those hands. This is our party. We came in a live like nobody was watching. Come on, city, come on, come on. Learn from the failure, gain humility, keep marching. Here we go, baby. Can't hold us.
can't hold us.
Ago, someone told me I should take caution when it comes to love. I did, and you were strong and I was not. My illusion, my mistake, I was careless, I forgot. I did, and now when all is done, there is nothing to say. You have gone so effortlessly. You have won, you could go ahead, tell them all I know now. Shout it from the rooftops, write it on the skyline. All we had is gold now. Tell them I was happy and my heart is broken. All my scars are open. Tell them what I hoped would be impossible. Broken trust and broken hearts. I know. Thinking all you need is there. Building faith on love and words. Empty promises will wear. I know. And now, when all is gone, there is nothing to say. And if you're done with embarrassing me, on your own, you could go ahead. Tell them all I know now. Shout it from the roof. Caution when it comes to love, I did. Tell them all I know now. Shout it from the rooftop. Told me I should take caution when it comes to love. I did.
If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river at dawn, send me away with the words of a love song. Lord, make me a rainbow, I'll shine down on my mother. She'll know I'm safe with you when she stands under my colors. Oh, and life ain't always what you think it ought to be. No, ain't even gray, but she buries her baby. The sharp knife of a short life. Well, I've had just enough time. If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down.
Here we are pulling into the town of Batoche, which is where the Métis made their final stand against the Canadian government. This is a Canadian historic site. It was very important in the development of Canada and the formation of Canada. So this is the church in the town. This is inside the church, and when the Canadians came, this was actually the first time that a Gatling gun was used, and you can see the bullet holes here in the side of the building. So lots of history here, lots of things to read up on later on in the trip, but the next stop after this was Calgary, Alberta, so another 800 kilometers. Here was a neat little ferry crossing that just happened to stumble upon. And keep enjoying the prairies, because there's lots more of them.
For my thoughts, oh no, I'll sell them for a dollar. They're worth so much more after I'm a goner. And maybe then you'll hear the words I've been singing. Funny when you're dead, how people start listening. If I
start me and my broken. perfect start. Me and my broken heart. Whoa, whoa. Me and my broken heart. Whoa, whoa.
Me and my broken.
I don't wanna be lonely no more. I don't wanna have to pay for this. I don't want another lover at my door. It's just another heartache on my list. I don't wanna be angry no more. You know I can never stand for this. So when you tell me that you love me, know for sure I don't wanna be lonely anymore. All I need is a little love in my life. All I need is a little love in the dark. A little, but I'm hoping it might kickstart me and my broken heart. I need a little loving tonight. Hold me so I'm not falling apart. A little, but I'm hoping it might kickstart me and my broken heart.
Here we are coming into Calgary, Alberta, a beautiful town right beside the Rockies. Lots of skiing available. Banff is very close. Jasper's close. A great city to be in. This is a shot from outside of Calgary in the Albertan Badlands. You're driving through the prairies and all of a sudden you dip down into this big gorge, which is known as the Badlands, and which actually makes for a site where they dig out the world's most preserved dinosaur bones, which is found in Drumheller, Alberta. So these few shots are from the Royal Tyrrell Museum in Drumheller, which has the best dinosaur specimens in the world. So spent lots of time here. The specimens were remarkable. You really got to sort of get involved in the preparation as well. You can see how they actually dig up the bones, how they prepare them with the molds and everything. It was really interesting. At this point, my friend from Ottawa, Sebastian, flew into Calgary. I picked him up, and here comes one of the best parts of the trip, which was the drive up to Whitehorse, Yukon. So 2,200 kilometers up to Whitehorse to do some backcountry camping.
Yeah. traveled to the USA to resurrect the recession.
So here you can see my driving become a little erratic, and for that reason was my car started making some funny sounds, which actually ended up being the wheel bearing gave out. So one of the wheels was vibrating violently, and this actually was a Saturday night. So we pulled into this town on a Saturday night, which meant Sunday there would be no mechanics open. So here we are in a parking lot in Grand Prairie, Alberta, pushing the car around, jacking it up. There you just saw it rise up. And we're trying to figure out which wheel bearing it is. Not that that matters, because they can't fix it till at least Monday. So we made a call. We really wanted to get to Whitehorse, and we weren't about to let a wheel bearing stop us. So we decided to drive another 1,500 kilometers through the Alaskan Highway on a bad wheel bearing.
And we laughed and had a really, really, really good time. Take my hand, let's have a blast and remember this moment for the rest of our lives.
Our lives,
our lives,
our lives. Our lives. Our lives. Oh, 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 oh.
Tonight,
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 tonight. Cause the night's the night, am I right? Dance.
Feels like a night for a party. My niche, so naughty. There's a knock on the door, it's the neighbors. Quick cock blocking, we're having a hoedown. You hoes down, don't let me pull my hose out. Cause it's big, long, pink, strong. I've been known to dance like all night long. Grab my hand, play this song. DJ, save my life, come on. Leave your fear, back off the wall. Free your beat and pussy pop. If you don't have a pussy, pop a cock into a boot tie. To a blue tie, yeah, yeah.
And we danced, oh, and we cried,
oh,
and we laughed,
oh,
and had a really, really, really good time.
Oh,
take my hand,
oh,
let's have a blast,
oh,
and remember this moment for the rest of our lives.
I am not going to stand on the wall. I will dance, I will dance, I will break that ass off. And I see you in the corner, corner looking so small, doing the robot like if I died tonight, at least I went hard. I will not give a damn who watches me. I will live, liberate the thoughts in me. I will be the disco ball freak and give my all to whatever girl's booty I'm freaking on. I'm not skeeting, nah, it's just freaking hot.
Alright, I skeeted.
I will not be a mannequin,
no,
the ego banish it. The roof's on fire, let's burn down the Vatican. I will moonwalk to Pluto in honor of Michael Jackson. In heaven he'll be saying that man is tired of dancing. Rip to the king, Michael Jackson. We learned it all from you. Dedicate this to the dance floor. Party out the sorrow till tomorrow morning happens. We pledge allegiance to the DJ. Put your hands up.
And we danced,
oh,
and we cried,
oh,
and we laughed,
oh,
and had a really, really, really good time.
Oh,
take my hand,
oh,
let's have a blast,
oh,
and remember this moment for the rest of our.
You see me looking at you from that bar right over there, but your friends are huddled up and they are hating on a player.
I just wanna dance with you, get on the back of you, tip tap the boots, extract the truth, dance with you, get on the back of you.
And we cried, and we laughed, and had a really, really
eyes are open wide.
Here we are on the second day going up to Whitehorse, Yukon, and we've covered about 800 kilometers since Grand Prairie, Alberta, and we're just about to pull up to Summit Lake, which is actually the highest point on the Alaskan Highway at about 1,500 meters. And we just parked our car here beside the lake, and that's where we spent the night. It was absolutely frigid, but it was beautiful, absolutely beautiful. There was lots of animals around. There were some caribou, there were some goats along the road. It just true backcountry, and it was a great place to spend the night. Luckily, we had enough food in the car, and we woke up early the next morning and kept on going. Here we are pulling into Muncho Lake. We gave this gas station a try. Unfortunately, my car needs 91 octane gas, and a lot of gas stations on the Alaskan Highway don't have that. So when you see us pull into a gas station and try again later, that's why. This is Muncho Lake, British Columbia, a beautiful town with a resort on it. And this resort is completely off the grid. It's all powered by diesel generators. All food is trucked in from Grand Prairie, Alberta. A bag of flour costs 60% more by the time it gets shipped here. They have a great vacation package where for a couple hundred dollars you get flown out into British Columbia backcountry onto a lake where there's no roads, no people, and there's just a cottage waiting for you with food, supplies, a canoe, and that's where you can go fishing and hunting for 4 or 5 days, and that's when you get picked up again. So definitely a place I'd like to go and visit again.
Take
as we were driving along the highway, you see signs saying bison crossing, and Seb and I laughed. We didn't quite know what to expect until we finally reached these guys. And what happened was there was simply 50 to 60 bison just walking on, along, and across the road. So your only chance with these guys is to stop and take pictures, because they're stunning animals. They weigh up to 800, 900 kilograms. We're easily the size of my car, and we're just standing in the middle of the road. So all we could do is admire them, and that was definitely one of the highlights of the trip, because it's so unexpected. It just happens, so we had to keep going.
First place, I don't support the team. I can't take direction, and my socks are never clean. Teachers dated me, my parents hated me. I was always in a fight, cause I can't do nothing right. Every day I fight a war against a mirror. I can't take the person staring back at me. I'm a hazard to my.
Here we are, finally arriving into Whitehorse, Yukon, 2,200 kilometers since Calgary. covered the Alaskan highway on a wet, bad wheel bearing, and it was simply stunning. The weather is interesting. It's cold, yet it's raining. The trees get smaller and smaller the further you go north, and it's just really beautiful nature, really interesting. So we pulled into the town here, and we got some recommendations on where to go backcountry camping. We found a mechanic to actually fix my wheel bearing. Believe it or not, they had the parts up in the Yukon. And we just enjoyed the town and quickly got out of the town, because what we were really here for was Kwanee National Park, which was to do our backcountry camping, see the glaciers, and enjoy the backcountry. There's Seb and I before our trip, but we didn't look that happy after. And all the supplies that we brought onto the trip. And that was our first campsite from the first evening. And lots of bear prints. That's my hand. That's a bigger bear print. And some friends that we met on the glacier as we were doing the trip. So after this, it was back to Grand Prairie, Alberta. I didn't want to record that again, so we just jumped back 1,500 kilometers into Alberta, and our next stop will be Jasper.
Keep drinking coffee, stare me down across the table while I look outside. So many things I'd say if only I were able, but I just keep quiet and count the cars that pass by. You've got opinions, man, we're all entitled to them, but I never asked. So let me thank you for your time and try not to waste any more of mine. Get out of here fast. I hate to break it to you, babe, but I'm not drowning. There's no one here to save. Who cares if you disagree? You are not me. Who made you king of anything? So you dare tell me who to be? Who died and made you king of anything? Oh, oh, oh. You sound so innocent, all full of good intent. Swear you know best, but you expect me to jump up on board with you right off into your delusional sunset. I'm not the one who's lost with no direction, oh, but you'll never see. You're so busy making maps with the name on them in all caps. You got the talking down, just not the listening. Who cares if you disagree? You are not me. Who made you king of anything? So you dare tell me who to be? Who died and made you king of anything? All my life I've tried to make everybody happy while I just hurt.
Here we're entering into Jasper National Park. You have to pay to enter this park and you get a ticket. So what they're trying to do is actually preserve the park. You could have millions of people come through here, just walk through, and they would devastate the ecosystem. So they use this to limit how many people come in, and then the proceeds are used to, again, maintain and preserve the park. So the name of the game is really preservation, which is great. On both sides of your screen, you can see giant peaks just jutting out of the ground. If you love camping or hiking or anything outdoors, I mean, this is the place to be. And the next few minutes are just going to be from Jasper down to Athabasca Glacier, down to Lake Louise, and then Banff. So enjoy the scenery.
I need to push.
after finishing up in Banff, I actually went back to Calgary for a few days and Banff and alternated between those two and went to Head Smashed in Buffalo Jump, which is another Canadian National Historic Site, and it's a museum that outlines how the Plains natives in the area actually hunted bison. So it was actually a lot more intricate than just herding them off a cliff. So there's more details on that in the notes below. But this is back in the prairies, and we're driving now towards Vancouver, right along the American border, down with Montana and Washington. So that's about 1,400 kilometers through the Rockies, just beautiful BC backcountry again, so enjoy. In the middle of the Rockies. So I didn't know about this, and as I stumbled upon it, it was really interesting because I was driving through vineyards. So really beautiful temperature. I mean, it was 30 degrees Celsius. It's almost like a desert in the middle of the Rockies, and beautiful, lots of expensive property, wine, and beautiful scenery.
About you. you're on my
into gorgeous Whistler, British Columbia. Beautiful skiing, beautiful mountains. The views from the top of the mountain were absolutely stunning. Season pass is about $1,600, but it's definitely worth it. So here I am on the top of the mountain at about 2,100 meters, doing some silly stuff. These are some common views that you see from the chairlift. Just stunning Rockies. After this, it was a quick jump over to Vancouver Island to Tofino, where we tried to learn how to surf. Had lots of fun, but this was also some of the darkest skies that I've ever seen, so I managed to catch some gorgeous shots of the Milky Way. After this, it was a jump down to Victoria, which was technically my final destination, but at this point, I was just so full of impressions and experiences that I said, no way I'm stopping. So even after Victoria, I had to keep going.
Straight in the sunshine. girl, come on. Listen to me.
Ooh, hey baby, even though I hate you, I wanna love you.
I want you. Ooh,
and even though I can't forgive you, I really want you.
I want you.
Tell me, baby, why can't you leave me? 'Cause even though I should've wanted, I gotta have it.
I want you. Ooh, yeah. Yeah.
In no time I'll be forgetting all about you. Saying that you know, but I really, really doubt you. Understand my life is easy when I ain't around you. Mitchie, Mitchie, too biggie to be here stressing. I'm thinking I love the thought of you more than I love your presence. And the best thing now is probably for you to exit. I'll let you go, let you back. I'll finally learn my lesson. No half-stepping, either you want it or you just playing. I'm listening to you knowing I can't believe what you're saying. There's a million you as baby boo, so don't be dumb. I got 99 problems, but you won't be one. Like what?
Head in the clouds, got no weight on my shoulders. I should be wiser and realize that I've got
Here we are pulling into Victoria, British Columbia. This is 52 days into the trip, 13,397 kilometers on the odometer. It was a great time, great trip across Canada. I learned so much about Canada's history, and as I was sitting there, I just didn't want to drive back to Ottawa just yet. So I decided I'm going to do as much of the States as I was able to do. So my next stop was down to Portland, so Vancouver to Portland.
It's our little party, just us two, just us two.
I really tried to avoid driving at night as much as possible, both for safety reasons, but also that I could actually see what I'm driving past. But sometimes it just didn't work any other way, so I had to pull into a couple of the cities at nighttime, which, I mean, you do what you can, so.
Tell me what I say. Oh, I wanna know.
Here we're pulling into Berkeley, California. Definitely one of my favorite parts of the trip. Beautiful camping, beautiful nature, beautiful museums, and beautiful towns all around. Definitely one of the highlights. The famous Golden Gate Bridge. A shot from when we went camping. Camping right beside the Pacific Ocean. I mean, surfing, anything you want is there. So definitely one of my favorite parts. At this point, I simply started crashing. This was after about 114 days on the road. I simply had no more energy to keep going, so I decided I'm going to drive back from Berkeley to Ottawa in one weekend, which is 4,800 kilometers. So everything you see up until Sarnia, Ontario, which is 4,000 kilometers away, was done in one weekend.
I'm not afraid to die. don't hurt me no more.
This is what we're waiting for.
this is end of day one, so I managed to do Berkeley, California, all the way to Little America, Wyoming, or a Little America stop in Wyoming. 1,400 kilometers in the first day. At the end of that first day, it started snowing, so I went from 20 degrees Celsius to minus 20 and a blizzard. It was 10 o'clock in the evening, and I simply couldn't see in front of me anymore. So as you can see, everything's covered in snow and ice, so this is early on in the next morning.
Moonshine, teardrop in my eye, country road. Take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama. Take me home, country road. I hear her voice.
Yeah.
This is end of day two, somewhere in Iowa. I'm not entirely sure. I think it's about 100 miles before Des Moines, Iowa. Again, another blizzard, but in this day I managed to actually cover 1,500 kilometers, so it was a good day. Just crashed in my hotel room that night and kept driving the next day.
Thank you.
here we are coming back into Sarnia, finally back on Canadian soil. First thing I celebrated with was some donuts from Tim Hortons. That was very good. And I stayed there for a couple days and then made it over to Toronto to visit some more friends, and then Ottawa a couple days later. So this drive right here was actually the worst drive I've ever had. It was a snowstorm, a blizzard between Sarnia and Hamilton. My all-season tires were not enough for these conditions, so a couple times it got a bit hairy, but I still made it through. So the next few minutes are actually pretty interesting.
Smoke, tell me a dirty joke. Up on your roof, up on your roof.